Hello and welcome to DFS Coach Talk. Today is Sunday, September 28th, and I am Joe Sarvati, affectionately known as Coach, and I'm running solo tonight to go over the one-game showdown, Game 6, Miami Heat-Boston Celtics game. So very excited to go over this. Using a little upgrade in some of our audio equipment here. So, please feel free to let me know, you know, either through YouTube or Twitter or for our members in Discord. Let me know if the sound quality is markedly different. I'd love to get some feedback on that. So great to have you. It was a fun night. Definitely enjoyed watching LeBron finish out, which was an incredible performance by a guy that just seems to not be losing anything whatsoever. I mean, his all-around game right now is just, you know, off the charts. Unbelievable. The level that he's playing at with this many years in the league is truly incredible. So we definitely know we have the Lakers in the finals. And tomorrow is a possible closeout game for the Miami Heat, or I should say later today, since it's technically middle of the night, basically. But yeah, it could be a closeout game. Celtics certainly have a great chance to push it to a game seven, and definitely going to be fun to watch the drama of that unfold. It is a night game, so it won't interrupt, you know, all the football fans trying to catch football throughout the day. So that is definitely a good thing. All right, so let's go over the betus.com.pa line for this game. It's a 7:30 p.m. start, and the Celtics remain a favorite, like they have been, I believe, in every game this series. It's been 3.5 point favorite for the Celtics throughout, and even though the Heat are up 3-2, the Celtics remain the favorite for this game, which is -3. They're -155 on the money line, and the over-under is 214. The implied total for Boston's 108.5, and for the Heat is 105.5. So, very interesting. For me, as far as this BetUS line, I really think the Heat are going to close the series out. That's my gut feeling, and I may play the Heat on the money line, which is +135, and not take the 3 points. I think they can close this out, and I think that makes for a really nice play. As far as the over-under, I think that's going to be close. That's what I'm figuring, right around that 214 number, so I'm not going to throw anything out there on that one. Hopefully somebody out there has a good feel for it, but I just think that's going to be too darn close for me to go with. I think I'm just going to stick with the Heat side. So, but we're here to talk some major DFS, and very, very excited to do that. We are on, again, a wonderful streak. We're still knocking them dead. Had some great showdown slate stuff this evening. We gave out a full winner lineup on FanDuel. And then, you know, the real exciting part is, I've mentioned it on quite a few of the pods. I love playing those two gamers where you have to wait for the next day to get the second game. But really a great start for us. For those that played my core four on DraftKings for the two-game slate, and I also gave out a full lineup for the two-game slate on Yahoo, they're both looking really, really sweet. I mean, like possible takedown sweet, with this game for Boston-Miami to finish it out. So hopefully a lot of you listened in to the podcast that Andrew and I did yesterday. We sort of talked a bit about that strategy and the two-gamer as well, and would love if you guys were riding that sweat with me tomorrow night. All right, as I mentioned, now that we checked our betus.com.pa odds, that is our presenting sponsor as well, and I would strongly recommend that you give them a try. You can either go to their website or you can go to dfscoachtalk.com and sign up with the promo code COACHTALK, all one word, no space, and you receive 125% on your first deposit match. So if you're putting in 100, you get 125 free play to get after it. And BetUS has everything. I mean, they've got casino, racebook, Madden, esports, all kinds of stuff going on. A lot of fun contests, but the best sports book and the biggest sports book in the States. And we're very, very proud to really be rocking and rolling and riding with them. In fact, let's just do this right at the jump start. We move it around, but I think this would be the perfect time for us to take a quick second and listen directly to my man at BetUS with the awesome voice tell you what a fantastic offer they have and how both BetUS and DFS Coach Talk have teamed up. So listen in real quick.
Wake up, sports bettors. Sports are in high gear at BetUS.com, so put down the beer and make every sporting event more exciting by putting stakes on the line at BetUS. Earn bragging rights over your friends as you rake in the cash from each week's betting action. But don't settle for any other book. Choose America's favorite sports book with over 25 trusted years in the industry, BetUS. You need a sports book with integrity and longevity, but more importantly, you need a sports book that pays. BetUS has your game with action on football, baseball, basketball, MMA, golf, horse racing, and even esports. No other sportsbook welcomes newcomers like BetUS with their jaw-dropping sign-up bonuses. Sign up now with promo code COACHTALK for 125% sign-up bonus up to $2,000. The best in the biz. Now you have the best book in the business with the best DFS provider in the business, COACHTALK. Create your account to make point spread bets, futures bets, prop bets, entertainment bets, live bets, and more. No other sportsbook is as committed to their members as BetUS. Sign up now and get in on the winning side of the ball.
All right. Thank you again to our partners at BetUS. All right, let's dive into this game. You know, showdown slates are always a little bit tough because, you know, you got to really hit it just right. It all comes down to, you know, strategy and how you're building that lineup out. And again, you know, the strategies are completely different on the main sites, specifically on FanDuel, where you have 2x, 1.5, and a 1.2. So you got to really ladder down those picks on how you want them to perform, how you think they're going to perform. And then on DraftKings, you just have your captain and then the five utility guys that go with them. So different builds, different strategy, and they also have different salaries just to make it a little bit more of a challenge. What I will say to start out with, the most expensive guy on both slates, on both sites is Jason Tatum. He's 16 on FanDuel and 15.9 on DraftKings. That's 15.9 as the captain. And the reason I'm touching on him first is, you know, I think he's got to be a key play in this game. He's, you know, as opposed to this last series that we just finished off, you know, you had LeBron, AD, and then, of course, the Joker and Murray. You had four super studs and then a big drop-off. There wasn't a lot of mid-level guys to build with. Even though it's a lot different with this series, you do have a ton of guys in that mid-pricing that you can build around. I wanted to start with Jason Tatum because I think he is the best player in this series on either team. I think he's the key to Boston staying in this game and possibly winning it. Even though I picked Miami, I think Boston is going to be right there, and I think Tatum will step forward. When he is going, he is an unstoppable force, either penetrating to the basket or hitting threes. So I really don't mind paying up for him. The big question is, you know, do you want to put him into that captain spot on DraftKings and spend that additional money? You know, that's the decision that we got to make. So on DraftKings at 15.9 for the captain, only 10.6 as a utility. FanDuel, it's a no-brainer. He's 16K. It doesn't change when you plug him in there, and he's going to be my captain. Like I said, I firmly believe he has the best chance to be the highest DFS point scorer in this game without question. And since you don't have to pay an inflated price to get the additional points on FanDuel, I think you just have to somewhat eat the chalk there and just play him. As far as other Celtics in this game, you know, that's where it's been, you know, hit or miss with some of these guys. You know, I think personally, the guy that I've just been most impressed with from a consistency standpoint is Jaylen Brown. I mean, he's had the potential to be really, you know, the 1A to the Tatum 1 along this entire path. But he's taken a little bit of a back seat to Kemba Walker and even Gordon Hayward, and been more of, you know, just another guy, you know, as a support guy on this team. But I think you've seen him evolve throughout the entire time in the bubble and in these playoffs. Very often when they need a big shot, he's the one taking that shot, even over Tatum at times. So I would say those two are, the without question, been the crunch time players for the Celtics. So at 12-5 on FanDuel, I think that's extremely fair, and makes perfect sense. You know, if you go over to DraftKings, you've got him at 8-6, which is even a better bargain. He's cheaper than Bam and Butler and just slightly more than Walker. So, you know, my question is, do I want to play Jaylen as the captain or have Jaylen and Tatum as two utility guys? Right now I'm leaning towards Tatum and Brown in the utility spots on the pricing, but using both of them as my main two Celtics. As far as the other Celtics, I have not gone to Kemba much at all in the playoffs. I mean, his price has been inflated, and really, and his you know, performance has been somewhat inconsistent. And I just, you know, I don't want to pay up for him. Marcus Smart is always dependable and solid. You know, he's not a great shooter, and at times, you know, you're talking about now at his price on FanDuel at 11 and his price 7-6, which is much more reasonable on DraftKings. I think he's more in play on DraftKings, but I don't particularly want to pay up for him on either one because of the Tatum-Brown duo that I'm already extended on. Same exact feeling for me for Hayward. I know he's playing big minutes, but, you know, I think we all expected too much too quick for him. You know, he came back and his first game back played 30 or 32 minutes and did pretty well. But, you know, he's obviously not in a groove. I mean, you can't miss that amount of time and just jump back in and blow it out. You know, it just doesn't happen. So, I think he's a solid fade for me again. You know, the guy that I've played throughout the playoffs for the Celtics has been Daniel Tice. He's getting big minutes. He's finishing games. He's statistically been steady, but not fantastic. And unfortunately, his price has now crept up. He's 9,500 on FanDuel, and he's 5,600 on DraftKings, which isn't bad. But you got to remember, throughout most of these playoffs, he's been in the 4,000s, 46. I think his max was 52. So we've gotten such a good break from him when we roster him from the financial side that it's been, you know, really a good play. Because even when he just has an average game, you know, he's getting to that 5X area. However, again, with that price going up, I think as far as the Celtics go, it's an elimination game for them. Their main guys are going to get extra minutes. I think their two go-to guys have been, without question, Tatum and Jaylen Brown. So those are going to be the two Celtics that I'm going to build with. and then I'm going to fill out the rest of my roster with Miami Heat players. And here's my reasoning behind that. I think if you've watched the Heat throughout here, Spoelstra is such a fantastic coach. He's had games where I think he's had emphasis games where they felt they really had to win that specific game throughout different times of the playoffs. And his rotation shrinks 7-8 guys max, and the main guys get the majority of the minutes. And then games where he feels like this last game against Boston, where yes, they want to close it out, but it's not a desperation game. They're up 3-1, and you see him extend that bench a little bit because he's always thinking about the next game or the next couple of games or where they can go from there. That's part of the reason he's such a fantastic coach. So, you know, for example, the last game, you see guys like Solomon Hill in there. You get an extended run from Iguodala. Kelly Olynyk got a small bit of run, even though he hadn't played the game before. But I think, without question, they want to close this out for multiple reasons. You know, if they let Boston sneak this one back, anything can happen in a game seven. All bets are off at that point. So, this is a very important closeout. They know the Lakers have already closed out. You know, they want to make sure and not have an extended 6 or 7 game where they still have a lot left for that finals. I mean, there's a multitude of reasons, but I think they lay it all on the line in this game, and you're going to see some extended minutes from their main guys. You know, to begin with, you got Bam Adebayo, who was dinged up. He was limping around a little bit out there. He's playing really good ball, and he's going to get monster minutes. And he is their main rebounder, their main inside player. And I can see that he's going to get a lot of ownership. He's going to be very, very chalky. There's no question about it. The question is, do you go there? I'm going to go there, and I haven't been strong on Bam throughout this. I've been riding the guards a lot more. But in this scenario, I think, you know, Bam's just a must. I think it's just an advantageous spot for him. I think he's going to play as many minutes as needed. I'm hoping that his ownership goes down a slight bit from everybody seeing that he was dinged up, limping around a little bit, etc. But I think he's fine. I think he's going to go whatever is needed. I really like him in this game, and he's my top guy, definitely from the Heat, which is unusual because I have not been going that way. But I think that this is just, like I said, a great spot for him. He's definitely going to be in one of the captain spots for me as far as the two, the 1.5 or 1.2 on FanDuel. As far as the captain spot, you know, his pricing in that is 14-1, which is costly in the captain spot on DraftKings, but that's the direction I'm going to go. I think there's enough value that you can still build out your roster if you have Bam as your captain and then Tatum and Jaylen Brown. Now, yes, that, you know, if you start your lineup with those three, with Bam as the captain, it leaves you 55-66. So, you know, almost 5,600 per guy for those final three. And let's discuss that a bit here on the DraftKings side of things. You know, if you want to go way down and take a risk, you know, you have Enes Kanter at 2,200. He got some good run this last game and seemed to be effective after sitting the game before. He is an option without question. Kelly Olynyk, I'm not going to go there. Sat a game, played very few minutes, but I'm sure a lot of people will take a quick gander at him. I think that the guys, you know, in a closeout game like this, I think Iguodala might see a little extra run just because of his experience. And in the clutch, they're going to need him defensively. And again, being able to stack up at the top with Bam, Tatum, and Brown specifically, You don't have to have guys completely smash at the bottom. You just have to find a way to round out that roster. And then, you know, these are the three guys, the other three guys I'm looking at with the others that I mentioned, that a combination of these guys you can fit with, because I'm trying multiple different ways to look at it. But they would be Duncan Robinson at 5,000 and Jay Crowder at 6,200, and we're talking DraftKings. So that combination of guys, and also slightly, I mean, Daniel Tice is in there at 5,600. And I like him as well. I don't like that his price is up a little bit. But I think if you take that combination, and you're not going to be able to go to a Dragic or Hero, and I've been, you know, those guys have really been fantastic for me. But I'm going to count more on Bam, more of this game being on the interior. I think Boston can be attacked a little bit more at the rim. And they're getting out there and putting more pressure on Dragic, and certainly not letting Hero get the looks. This last game, they dogged him pretty good, and he regressed. So, I think he'll do fine. But again, his price has gone up. He's 7,200 on DraftKings. So I think if you stick with that build of Bam, Tatum, and Brown, and you can pretty much shuffle around who you want as the captain, again, I'm leaning towards Bam. And then use that combination, and I'm going to finalize this throughout the day tomorrow, and I'll be putting the final touches on this in Discord for our members. And that group, again, that I'm considering is Enes Kanter, Andre Iguodala, Duncan Robinson, Daniel Tice, and Jay Crowder. Not all stars by any stretch, but solid guys that are going to all get 20-plus minutes, in my opinion, and be able to finish out a takedown-style lineup. All right, let's shift over to FanDuel. Before we do that real quickly, though, follow us tomorrow as much as you can, because we're going to be posting information. I know everybody's watching football on Sundays and super busy. But just, take a peek at your Twitter once in a while and see what we're posting there. All of us are at DFS Coach Talk. I'm at Joe Sarvadi, Joesarvadi. Andrew is at Language Olympic, and Shane is at DET Sports Shane. So check us out. And then if you'd like to become a member, we would love to have you. Go to DFSCoachTalk.com. You can sign up for a week, a month, a year. Or if you want to try our fall special, which runs throughout the end of the year, it's $199. It's designed for, the football big fanatics, because it runs through the entire football season. But everything we do at Coach Talk is inclusive. So if you join, you're in our Discord, you get all four sports that we provide for. That's PGA, NFL, NBA, and Major League Baseball. We've had fantastic success in all of them, riding a real hot streak specifically in basketball and football. And again, you get all of that, our coaches clipboard on DraftKings, full lineups on FanDuel and Yahoo, and get to mix in there in Discord with our pros. We have the best members in the industry, extremely smart, intelligent folks in there. They're all constantly sharing great information. I was just in there tonight with Laker Zen, who's always got some incredible stuff. Our man Roush from Australia was in there with me tonight. Matrix Dave, who's newer, and Josh Joshy Q. I almost said Josh IQ. He doesn't like that. And I got to do it the right way, Joshy Q. And those guys are crushing it with me. One of our first annual members, JP Wild, he's our Canadian champion up there. Broncos fan 001 was in there with us. X-Man 1161, DG 90 50 51, he's awesome. Gotta mention just a few more, because it's the group of us together that talk this stuff through, gut it out, sweat it out, figure it out, And that makes a lot of difference, and it's so much fun. Last few I want to mention, one of our brainiest, best sports guys in our chat room is Tyler Pitzer. We love him. Great input that he throws in there, as well as Slim to Goat 78. And I could go on and on. Bond 213. Just, you know, we've got the best group that there is out there. And, you know, not only is it Shane in there and Andrew and Dawson and Leighton and Brett and Bryce, our team, but you get all the rest of those guys in there just with ideas, sharing information. You know, it's been awesome in baseball. You know, everybody checking the weather. Everybody's in different locations all over the country and in Canada and in Australia. You know, we have members everywhere. So it's great stuff. We'd love to have you in there. And just like I say, go to dfscoachtalk.com. Hit the button there to join. And all of it's self-explanatory. It'll send you an email right away. And you can be in Discord within like 5 minutes of signing up. So we would love to have you join us. And this is the perfect time to do it. We've got Major League Baseball playoffs starting this week. Of course, we're going to have the NBA Finals here, and then NFL just in full gear, big time right now. And we're having a blast with PGA. I mean, PGA is still red hot because of the COVID stuff. Their major tournaments are all in different spots, so we're getting a lot of those spread out. You know, we've got, I believe, the Masters coming up still, too. So join us for all those. We love it. We're having fun. And we definitely love to have you join us. If you're watching us right now, by the way, this is super important. This is the only thing I always ask every podcast. If you're watching us on YouTube, please hit the thumbs up and also subscribe to our channel. We are growing so fast from the subscription side on YouTube. We're shooting right up the charts there, and that's super important to us because we want to continue to beat that algorithm on YouTube and get a higher ranking. So when people are searching for a DFS listener or provider, they're going to find us. So we really, really appreciate that. We keep all of our podcasts in front of the paywall. Right now we're doing 11 per week between our different sports, and that's probably going to continue or go up even more as we go forward. So you know, if you're on YouTube with us, the thumbs up is huge. Subscribe to us and hit that little alarm alert button there on the right side of your screen. That will let you know anytime a podcast posts for us, and that is fantastic. If you're listening to us on audio, which we have a lot of real dedicated podcast listeners there that have followed Andrew and I back a couple of years now, as we've been doing a basketball podcast together for a long time. We would love for you to join in the contest that we have monthly. It is for our iTunes and Spotify listeners. If you give us a 5-star on iTunes and post a comment, that qualifies you for the drawing. And if you follow us on Spotify, that also qualifies you. And we do a drawing each month. We only have 4 days left until this month's drawing. And it's for a 1-month free membership with DFS Coach Talk. So definitely jump in there. You can find us everywhere podcasts are heard. We're on Apple Podcast, iTunes, like I said, Spotify, Podbean, iHeart, Stitcher. We're everywhere. So definitely appreciate any positive feedback you can give us on any of those. All right, let's dive into FanDuel a little bit here. We've already gone through some of it as far as how we're breaking down that top three in the three important spots and just determining which order we want to put them in. Right now, I've got it as Tatum, Adebayo, and then Brown. Again, those are the three key plays for me tomorrow. There's only two spots to fill here on FanDuel. And with those three, if you do follow that build with me, it leaves you 17,000. So you can average 8,500 for these two spots. So it does eliminate, like we expected, you know, the Kembas and Tyler Heroes, Smarts and Dragic's and Hayward's, but this is who is in play, and it's a very similar cast to who we were looking to fill out our roster on DraftKings. And I'll give you the feel for how we'll be able to look at this. You've got Crowder at 95, Tice at 95, Duncan Robinson at 9. And then you have a drop-off to Wanamaker, who's not in play for me. But you have Kanter at 7,000, which is definitely a consideration. And then the other guy that I would consider at 6,500 is Andre Iguodala. So that's the core of guys, like I say, very similar to what we were filling out with. I think anybody else is just too much of a risk. I mean, you know, you can't, obviously, you got to be a little picky with who you're putting in there. But, you know, to take a chance at taking a guy that's either not going to play or get, you know, 5-6 minutes, you just can't risk it. And, you know, I'm more of a cash player, so I have a tendency to build a little bit safer lineups. But I don't play chalk very often. I mean, I don't think this lineup's going to be dead chalk either. I think you're going to have a lot of Jimmy Butler. You're going to have a lot of Kemba Walker, certainly Tyler Hero, Dragic, Smart, Hayward. Those guys are all going to get a lot of play. So it's not certainly chalk, but, you know, it's not being contrarian to the point, you know, where you're going to just take yourself right out of contention. So you don't want to have to play catch up. But I think if you stay with that general build for both, you'll do just fine. Yahoo's similar. I mean, they follow the prices pretty closely. You can build some very interesting, lineups there. They do have some good contests. They, you know, nice thing about Yahoo's, they do have some overlay. Some of their tournaments don't fill, and certainly the selection's not anywhere close to what you get on DraftKings or FanDuel, but I've found it to be a fun site. The pricing, like I say, is different, follows the same pattern, but way less pricing. Like the highest guys, $55, they go all the way down to like $7. So it's just a different look and feel when you build it. But I think you can find some good contests there if you want to mess around with it. Also, we have, if you become a member and you're in our Discord, we have wonderful offers if you're going to join any of them for the first time. If you've just played one site, like a lot of new members that come in have only played DraftKings, for example, and haven't played anything else. And I always strongly recommend, you know, I'm not saying double your bankroll, you know, play with the bankroll you figured out is good for you. But it really helps to be on at least the minimum DraftKings and FanDuel. I mean, that's a necessity. And I think Yahoo's a good third option to have in there. And the reason I say that is, as you're building these lineups, as we're breaking stuff down, there's going to be some mispricings on one or the other or one of the three. There's going to be, you know, something that's out of whack where you can really get a big edge. And, you know, there are days that, you know, I'll play 70% maybe on DraftKings, 20% on FanDuel, 10% on Yahoo, and then the pricing and the way the contests line up the next day, it may flip. I may be 60% FanDuel, 20 Yahoo, and 20 DraftKings. So, you know, having those options and being able to fluctuate between them based on the contests offered and the pricing is extremely key. So definitely, you know, take that into consideration. You know, some people feel like, okay, if my budget is I'm playing, you know, $50 on DFS per day, and they're on two sites and they feel they have to pay $100, that's not how you want to do it. You want to spread it out, you know, keep your bankroll management the way you have it, and just be more selective of the multiple opportunities you have on the different sites, so that you can maximize, you know, where you feel your best plays are going to be and you're going to get the best conducive pricing to building a winning lineup. So strongly recommend that. If you want to, you know, listen back to any of our podcasts, you can go on YouTube. We have a great library there. We have some great ones with talking specifically about what I just stated, that the different sites, what they offer, how the scoring is different, you know, the best way to bankroll manage, the best way to make contest selection, you know, all of those things matter tremendously. I think people just think, okay, who are the best guys? Throw them in there and go. There's the preparation before you actually roster your team, to me, is as important or more important than rostering the team. And I know that sounds silly, but it's true. If you take the time and you figure out what contest you want to get in, see what the rake is, see how many people are in there. You know, if it's super high weighted at the top, you know, and doesn't pay well, you know, it's people that play and get frustrated because they'll play with in a 10,000 entry tournament, finish 150th and turn $4 into $8. I mean, you know, it drives you nuts doing that. So you've got to find ways where you can be in contests where, yeah, it's fine, take your Millie Maker shot here and there, but be in contests where you get strong finishes, you're going to get paid for them, or, you know, there's less people in them. Single entries are a terrific way to do that. You know, so specifically look at those. Check out our YouTube podcasts that we talk about all of that stuff. And once you've done that and secured those spots, and for a lot of you that play a lot of football, get those contests reserved because you're going to get shuffled out of some of them because they'll fill. And then, you know, if you're with us, be in Discord at least a full 30 to 45 minutes before lock, because that's where we're going to talk about any player changes, injuries, weather. And unfortunately, with this crazy world we're in now, we've had things pop up with, you know, there's been COVID stuff that we've had to adjust lineups immediately. There's been games protested. They're not going to play, you know, with different things that have gone on across the country. So you've got that. You know, so there's all these unknown things and bubbles and everything. It's just a crazy situation. But what it does is it gives a big advantage to those people that are really following a system and following an approach. And that's what we do at DFS Coach Talk. You know, all of that, we think all of that through and we follow all of those steps. So if you want to turn it around, and I'll tell you, that's the best feeling I've had this last couple of weeks, especially, is the feedback from our members has been, you know, I've played DFS for years. I just, you know, I enter these GPPs, I bust and have to reload all the time. And we're just taking a completely new approach, fresh approach for everybody. You know, play more cash than you do GPPs. Build your bankroll. Make yourself successful. Set yourself up for success long term. Because DFS is a blast. It's fun. But it does cost real dollars to play. And, you know, if you want to sustain at it, win at it long term, we feel like we have the formula at DFS Coach Talk. So definitely join in. We'd love to have you. If not, that's cool too. You know, you can catch all of our thoughts just like this. I get on my soapbox when I get the microphone by myself sometimes. The coach in me comes out. But, you know, I really do want people to be successful. And, I, you know, I hate to see people that bust out and then can't play anymore. So that is about it, though. I think we've covered everything. If you have any questions, certainly reach out to us on YouTube, or you can catch us on Twitter, DFS Coach Talk, or if you want to tweet me directly, DM me. I answer everything as quickly as I can. If it's about a specific slate, I'll certainly try to get that info out before the slate locks, and be happy to help wherever I can. Last thing to mention, our charity of choice here at DFS Coach Talk is mambaon3.org. That's mambaonthree.org. It is a wonderful, wonderful charity set up by the Bryan family. So thank you so much for spending this time with me. I hope that you find your Sunday to be an extremely profitable and fun one in all the sports that you play. I know that Andrew and Shane will be working their tails off on their podcasts that will post early Sunday, so you'll be able to catch them and then jump in there with us throughout the morning as we get ready to take some stuff down. So again, thank you, appreciate you, and We will definitely be back again tomorrow when we look to crush it in DFS.